Jill are sitting in the car, and we've been talking at some point, and he puts the alcohol in her blood system, whatever, and you began to fall into a deep sleep. And it's all up to the Jill's car. Right outside my house. The windows got a little steamed up, of course, because they were all rolled up and it was raining out. Jill's on her side, Adam's on my side. I fell asleep and Jill's side. The driver's side. I don't drive, I can't afford it. Jill had fallen asleep, and while she fell asleep, she had fallen to the right in a slanting motion, so that she'd been quite close to me, and her head was somewhere on my chest or something like that. You know,
Text.
Sitting on my shoulder, and my head was pressed firmly against the glass in my window. And about 2:30, this woman in this pink bathrobe and these big glasses and this hair that had been just combed. You can tell she combed it, just came outside and yelled at us. She said it's 2:30 in the morning, and apparently she thought that we were having sexual intercourse or something. She was screaming loudly, "Open this door!
Oh my God!"
And we were disoriented as to what this neurotic woman was saying to us. She could tell me,
"Hey, you neurotic woman!"
She hadn't had a revelation.
"What are you saying to me?"
She was not left and she doesn't
"Hey, neurotic woman!
I went inside, and the next morning, I woke up in reality, and I was lectured.
Welcome to reality, son. We never should have taken you in. You're 17 years old.
Where's the job? Where's the job, son?
Well, I got a new job in architecture.
We haven't seen any weddings tonight yet, have we? You went to Philadelphia for how long, and you came back here, you quit your job before you left, gave him some wise ass excuse. I know, I've heard about it, I know your friends. You said, "Tell him I'm gonna commit suicide, or I have to commit suicide." You couldn't have called if you were dead, stupid. I figured that out. I bet you didn't think I could.
Well,
listen here, young man. Tell your friend to drive back home and never come back here again.
Or dinner will eat that stupid steak that you get from the meat man who brings it at the beginning of the month and fills that fucking freezer in the garage. And also bread and Twinkies that you buy for $1 at the ocean.
Twinkies! You say Twinkies?
At the beginning of the month, you tell us not to get into the Twinkies, yet you're so hypocritically,
and why did you those Twinkies?
I did not
love you.
I did not drink
we
those.
We gave you those Twinkies because we care. We gave you those Twinkies because you know we're thinking of you. I did it if you are not aware.
Hold your hair. So I said to my aunt, I said, "Well, you know, I gotta go to the library this morning.
Now I can't find that record I was looking for."
And like an hour or two later, I actually did go. And I got a book out on democracy, yet I didn't use my library card because I couldn't find it. I think I'll return that book someday. So I came over here and I found...
Where's here? Where are we?
The drug house! I came over to the drug house and I realized that today was indeed the premiere of our movie. We watched the movie and all these people came over and Dan started dropping LSD, that's lysergic acid diethylamine, that's 10 Babbage.
No.